Also, all right, deploying trash. This is a game that doesn't even exist according to Twitch. So I don't know what really to expect here, but it's something that looked like a good time for Sunday. It was recommended by the vetting team, and it just was, sure, bring it on. It's called Ozzy's World. So, whatever this is. Oh, it's so early 90s.
Huh? Can you come out and play?
No! Look at its face!
There's lots to do!
Yeah, there's lots to do.
You can come over to my house. We can play at the beach.
Bring your friends.
What is happening?
We can visit the vet. We can find neat stuff in the garden.
It's like...
Here too.
ADD cartoon on speed.
Whenever you want to go to a different place to play, just click on the signpost. Then click the map where you want to go. If you need help, click the ambulance. Okay, ready when you are.
It's like...
See ya!
For nothing happening, it's sensory overload. I haven't even pressed a button, and things are happening. Also, they stole that from a cartoon.
Can you come out and play?
I heard the cartoon's music.
There's lots to do.
I know. Shut up. Stop. Yeah. Okay, we did this. God damn it. I don't. Listen, when he skids, when he comes to a skid, you can hear the music from the Looney Tunes, or whatever cartoon it was. They didn't bother to get their own sound effect. They cut it from a cartoon on the TV. Did you hear it?
Can you come out and play? There's lots to do!
Yeah, there's lots.
Oh, thank God.
Come in, Annie! Annie, come in!
Roger, Ranger, Ranger. I just saw Ozzy over by the tent.
Ranger, Ranger, I think I see Ozzy by the cabin.
I wonder if any of the people...
I see Ozzy by the log.
...doing voice acting for this became famous...
Found
...afterwards.
Found ya, Ozzy!
Boy, you guys sure are good trackers. I bet you can't find all the stuff that's hidden in the forest.
Quick, let's go before they find us!
Wow. I don't know where to begin. Here's where I will begin. I am shocked at the amount of people in chat that say they had this game as a kid. And actually liked it. I've never heard of this, but then again, I've never heard of a lot of the games I've played on this stream. So never mind. It's totally normal. What? I guess if you're 6 years old and your brain matter is highly compacted, you might enjoy the, you know, bright colors and things, especially if you are, say, growing up in the early 90s, right? But I'm having a lot of trouble.
Hold the shift key down and click me again.
Understanding the appeal of this. Oh, well, I guess there's, you can draw. Maybe that's why. I'm an artist. I like that there's an ambulance button. If click this game makes you nauseous, bottom, click the
click
ambulance.
Part of the picture, and it'll change to that color.
Click here on the ambulance to get help. If this game makes you feel sick, press the ambulance to call an ambulance and go to the fucking hospital. Some would say I'm a trendsetter, a mold breaker, an iconoclast for the way I do my art. Yeah, that sounds kind of like the gnome fart a little bit. Gnome fart.
Ooh, hello, me old chums.
I couldn't mute it in time. I was going to mute it, and I didn't mute it in time. God damn it. I swear that's exactly what I was trying to do. I like that Splort 3 dot wave is still... still being used to this very day. Probably just sell this. I've seen contemporary, like, clothing that costs upwards of 80 to 120 bucks. That kind of looks like this anyway. Just like a splort of bright colors across the whole thing. And then they just sell it. It's on a shirt. It's basically Ringo making art, but non-ironically people buying it. I don't get it. I'm also out of touch. So that was a crayon.
When your chest opens, you found the buried treasure. Hold down the shift key and click once to uncover a game or experiment.
Hold the shift key down and click me again.
We need more volume. We need to hear this glorious music. What was that noise? Below, beside, in, or on?
No!
It's dead. The cat is now dead. Oh, this Whoa! Is just severed moose heads.
Whoa! Ah! Whoa!
This is Ozzy's silly sorter. Click on the ambulance if you need help.
Ozzy's Silly Sorter, drag the moving objects up to their correct match at the top of the screen. If you match the right one...
Whoa! Whoa! Ah!
I get it, I think. Man, this is too hard. What a weird fucking concept for a game this is.
Whoa!
And then you kill them. If you... What is that noise? What is that noise? I hate it.
Whoa.
I'm not very good at that video game then. Pretty bad, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good. Good animation. Games like this are why my dreams are so fucked up. Why is that funny? You know what's funnier is that 10,000 people are watching
Please,
this fucking garbage.
Don't litter.
There's probably like some big fucking tournament happening. Like people actually doing impressive things in video games. You know, and then the rest of us are just watching a fucking seahorse in a tree. Sorry, that's a armadillo? Stole a sock. Thought it was a seahorse, chat. I don't know. Okay. Oh my god. Wood makes those things. Someone just said penis sounds.
Hold the shift key down and click me again.
To play Ozzy's Puzzler game, drag the puzzle pieces to where you think they belong, then let go of the mouse button. If the puzzle pieces belong there...
Of course, the first one I pick up is just ass. Not even intentional. I don't think I want to play Ozzy's Puzzler game.
Hold the shift key down and click me again.
Oh, the Burn Ants minigame. I like this one.
Welcome to Ozzy's Hidden Picture Game.
Damn.
Click once on the ambulance if you need help. Click once on the stoplight to pause the game. Click it again to begin play.
I liked hidden object games when I was a kid. I might have enjoyed this. Listen, if I played this at the age of like 5 or 6, yeah, I probably would have liked a little bit of this. Or maybe a lot of it. God.
Not quite. Not.
It's basically a virtual, like, PC babysitter.
Not.
I thought that was just there. That I did. What? What?
Marshmallow. Not quite.
Marshmallow. Chat, am I missing something?
Marshmallow.
I'm not missing a marshmallow. What? Am I missing something? Did you?
Marshmallow. Oh.
Snail? That wasn't hidden. That was there already.
It's not a horse with stripes. What is it? Oh, almost. It's not a horse with stripes. What is it? Try again.
Cool air conditioner.
Try again. Oh. Not quite. Try. Oh, not. You're getting closer.
The fuck? I didn't see that. Why is it so tiny? Oh, because it's in the distance.
Marshmallow.
Vinny. Oh, marshmallow. That's why they were saying marshmallow. I thought it was just random wackies. Boy, I'm failing at a baby's game. Also, why is there like a corn texture on the outer edge of those games?
What did you do with that thing? It's like disturbing, like how big the hands and arms are compared to how small the size of the tent is. Oh no, it's Ozzy again.
Ozzy, I was hoping you would bring the supplies. We've been so busy.
I had so many stops. I filled my whole wagon. All these supplies are for your experiments.
These are all like
Arizona,
failed bootleg cartoons.
What are you doing here?
Well, Ozzy, I was patrolling the coast and spotted a couple of whales that had beached themselves. I sprained my wing helping them get back into the water.
Yeah.
I need to go and put the supplies away before Smudgy gets snorting mad. So I'll see you later.
Dude, snorting and doing experiments on animals.
Arizona, you're next!
If you think my story was good, wait until you hear what happened to my friends!
Oh, I forgot I can't fly.
Oh man, the Looney Tunes have no competition. The Dietlemores of my life are quite inconsequential.
Isn't your pet the cutest in the whole world? Nothing makes a dog happier than chomping down on a delicious homemade treat. If you want to spoil your dog, silly, because after all, it is the cutest dog ever to walk the earth, then make these yummy dog biscuits and you're going to need some help with this.
Wait,
one.
A fucking
Here's
recipe?
Here's a list of ingredients. The dry ingredients include 2 cups of whole wheat flour, 1/4 cup of cornmeal, 1/2 in a bowl, mix the dry ingredients. Add the other. Knead the dough for 5 minutes. Cut the dough into shapes. Make them like dog bones or any. Work! Bake on an ungreased cookie sheet at 350. Work! 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 Work!
It's a fever dream when you're, like, when you're a kid, this is probably, it's just like, oh, that's cool. But then when you're, like, my age and, you know, 1 foot in the grave, it's a fever dream.
Here, kitty, 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 kitty,
this
kitty.
Is also what games were like on the computer, on the DOS, on the Windows 3.1. I mean, games were just like this, and no one really questioned it. Then again, the market and audience for games was a lot smaller, so again, this is just a babysitter.
Mama, where's the ketchup?
Not ketchup. We're here for a checkup.
Oh.
That was like a Vine Sauce tier joke.
Oh, how'd you get hurt, Billy Bird?
I was flying low, looking this way and that, when...
All right, chat, guess how the elephant got hurt. Yes, the bird was telepathic, don't worry about it. How did the elephant get hurt? Shit his pants, was stoned, meth. No, really, like a real answer. Too many peanuts, poacher, he's depressed, ran into the bird, a mouse? Okay, good ones. All right, let's see if any of those were correct.
How did you get hurt, Trunky Elephant?
I can't remember.
Oh, but an elephant never forgets. God damn it. All that for that?
All right, this dude got hit by a train. What are you squirting? What do you squirt? Was that mustard? Are you squirting mustard? I don't think this pig is a real doctor. I'm beginning to think that this pig does not have a PhD. Oh, the mailman is a dog.
How did you get hurt, Randy Raccoon?
Stepped in a bucket.
I was filling this void bath, and do you believe it? I stepped in this pail.
That sounded like Charles Martinet doing the anal sphincter voice. That is also the lamest fucking way to get hurt. You're clogging up this fake doctor's office with bullshit. You don't belong here. You just step out of the pail.
How did you get hurt, Randy Raccoon?
I was filling this void bath, and do you believe it? I stepped in this pail.
So lame.
Attention all units, be on the lookout for a brown dog.
Hilarious.
Hold the shift key down and click me again.
Why do we have to hold the shift key down?
Welcome to Ozzy's Hidden Picture Game. Click once on the ambulance if you need help. Click once on the stoplight to pause the game.
This one is simple. I got this one. Fucking elephant was in there somehow.
There's a bottle somewhere on the floor.
I thought that wasn't... See, some of these things look like they're just there. Like, they don't look hidden, they are there.
Sometimes when you visit the doctor, he gives you a lollipop. Sometimes when you visit the doctor, he gives you a lollipop. You're getting closer. My friend Mr. Dog needs to take his vitamin. Can you help him find it?
What? What was that hidden object? Again! It was there! That wasn't hidden! Check the chair for some pills.
You're getting closer.
Oh, God. What else
is... I think it's time for a big slice of watermelon.
Oh, of course the clock was watermelon, obviously. Again, it's like corn. Like, why? Whoa. This like weird 3D corn background.
Find the scale. Try again.
Find the scale.
Find this. Try again.
Find the scale.
Try again. Find the scale. Try. You're getting. You're getting close. You're getting closer.
Oh, I had to click the.
You're getting closer.
Did I win? Did I win? Yep, I won. Definitely. What a cool...
Next!
We can go anywhere. I don't know why I'm still playing this, but...
Ozzy, your friend is here.
There you are. Did I show you my latest experiment? I was in my hideout working on it.
What do you mean experiment?
We can play with it later. Did you see my new sundial? It's over there, in the window.
Ozzy, don't forget to water the garden before you leave.
Okay, Mom! Let's have an ice cube race later. Why don't you just hang out and explore all my cool stuff while I water the garden? I'll be right back. Coming!
I don't know about cool stuff. First thing I see is a dirty old sock. Bat facts. Cheek tweets! This is not the right time for bat facts, I don't think. Chat, I don't know how I feel about this. What a fucking terrible place to live with where your paintings come to life. And your elephants, like, skeets. Is that one of your experiments? I wouldn't exactly call cooking a hot dog an experiment, but... if so, you're a genius, dude. Why that sound effect? I have to click shift for bat fact.
Bats are fascinating creatures that are very good to have around. But a lot of people are afraid of them because they don't know the facts. Unfortunately, there are a lot of rumors going around about bats that are exaggerated and completely untrue.
What was that word?
Make up some bat fact cards and share them with your friends. Help spread the good news about bats.
Maybe not. Maybe we don't. Maybe we just click exit.
Myth number one. Bats are like rats on a wing. They are flying rodents.
Did they record this with like the TV on in the background?
Fact number one. Bats are mammals. Like whales and humans, they are closer to us than they are to mice. Unlike mice, they only have one baby per year. As you can see, they are definitely not rodents.
But my stupid son, Alucard, he keeps riding his skateboard around town.
Yeah, I hear people in the background. There's either people speaking. Bats are mammals like whales and humans. They are not rodents. Wait, a rabbit isn't a rodent. Is a rabbit a rodent? Are rabbits rodents? No, rabbits are not rodents.
Myth number two. When you're out at night, bats will fly into your hair.
Myth.
Fact Fact number two. Don't flatter yourself. Bats have no interest in your hair. These remarkable creatures have a built-in radar system that is so accurate it enables them to catch little insects in the dark of night. They're certainly not going to blunder into your head.
Is there anyone that actually believed that? Like, where did that myth come from? I've never heard that myth.
Bats will suck your blood.
Okay, well, I've heard that one.
Huh. Bats don't suck your blood. Most bats eat fruit and insects.
That's just Dracula.
Only about 1 in 3,000 bats are the infamous vampire bats.
Infamous.
And they only live in Latin America. Those vampire bats inflict a small wound on an animal and drink a little blood from the wound. It's kind of like a big mosquito. The myth is that bats are dirty and carry lice or rabies. But actually, they are very clean little mammals. While it's possible for them to get rabies, it is not any more likely for them to have it than any other animal that can get it.
But, I mean, it's still, you gotta be careful. You know, like, don't go hanging out with them.
Here's a good one. Bats have poor eyesight. That's why we say someone is blind as a bat. The truth is that bats have excellent eyesight. The disinformation is based on the fact that they use the radar system to enhance their night vision. It helps them see in the dark, which is something that not too many species can do.
Oh yeah, yeah, we don't need pop filters. We don't have to turn the TV off while we're recording. We don't have to do more than one take. We can just go all the way through. Oh, we don't even need the correct information on some of this. It's fine. Yeah, some bats are blind, and they use sonar.
This is the worst myth. Bats are everywhere and plentiful. They are not at risk of extinction.
Risk?
This is not true. While bats can be found all over the world, there are many species that are endangered and at risk of extinction. This is partly because people kill them because they are afraid. To help save bats, contact Bat conservation.
I can't believe we learned about bats. I can't believe it. No, chat, they don't. They use their sonar. They have built-in radar. That's true. Oh, they also have thermal vision, and if they kill 3 people in a row, they get a kill streak. And they can they can call a UAV. Oh, snake. Yep. Wouldn't have predicted that one.
Hi. Do you look up at the sky at night to watch for falling stars? Have you and your friends ever wondered if there's life on other planets? Since our sun is really a star, do you suppose that any of the stars... Do you like to plan parties? Well, try this. Of course, check with Mom
like
and Dad
movies
to
about
see
gladiators?
If it's okay first. Plan a cosmic costume party for you and your friends. Pretend that your guests are coming from different planets all over the galaxy.
What?
Make up invitations that give directions to your home planet. Describe the Earth and how to get there if they were coming from all over the universe.
Did you ever want to throw a cosmic party? It's false. Never happened. This doesn't seem fun.
Do your parents like the idea? Fun, isn't it? Now you'll need some games to play. Let's make one. Make a game to play at your party by drawing a sun on a piece of stiff paper and cutting it out.
Why is it with stiff paper?
Put a thumbtack through it. Use another piece of paper or cloth and draw our solar system, leaving out the sun. When your guests arrive, you can play Pin the Sun in the Solar System. To play, have each person try one at a time to pin the sun in its correct place in your solar system. It's not as easy as it sounds, because before they try, you blindfold them. If it's still too easy, make it more challenging by spinning them around after you blindfold them. The one who gets closest to the right spot wins. That should be a big hit. Do you need a prize?
Vinny, are you having... No. This isn't like when I was streaming that VR Blade Runner-like game yesterday where I was on the verge of VOM. It was a VOM-com. No, I was just kind of imitating, like, her breathing noises while she's doing her lines are very noticeable, which is the shitty microphone's fault. But they're very deep breaths.
Your friends like to eat, don't they? Well, let's prepare.
I guess they do. Wait a minute. Your friends like to eat?
Your friends like to eat, don't they?
Well, no! No one likes to eat!
Make some special cosmic treats for your alien friends to eat. Perhaps some interstellar cookies and spaceship punch. Ask your mom about a punch bowl. Sounds great, doesn't it?
You gave me no information? You told me nothing? That's so lame! That's so lame. What is it telling me to do? Just, like, cut out some planets in the shape of cookies and then have mom make punch? Cosmic punch!
Well now, humans have sent signals out into the universe with messages for any intelligent life forms to discover. The messages are in picture form and tell all about the Earth and Earthlings. You and your friends can make picture messages describing your home planet. Your guests are from another planet, so have them tell about the people and their planet.
What year did this game come out? Hang on a second, I have to find out. Ozzy's World Game.
Ozzy's World includes the Otter's Adventure, Fun School Special, Young Scientist, and Ozzy's World Deluxe Edition.
1995. Okay, Mario 60, 1994 is Ozzy's World. Why not just play some Mario Kart instead of all this crap? You know?
Now, let's show your guests what it's like here. Together, you can all make a recording of the sights and sounds of Earth. Include songs, greetings, spoken messages, animal sounds, everything you can think of that would help an alien understand life on Earth and feel welcome visiting our planet. My, so many ideas! You'll have a great time. Don't forget your costume!
I really like that cosmic punch idea. That was a good one. Listen, on some level, I kind of understand what's going on here. It's just a little thing for kids to try out if they want to, like, do some mundane shit and pretend it's cooler than it is. But
light from
those cookies were fucking lame.
Bright. People wear visors when playing or watching sports, gardening, or working outdoors. In this activity, you can make a sun visor to wear on those wonderful sunny days.
If I made a sun visor at the age that I was supposed to be when this game came out, I would have fucked it up so bad. Anytime I ever tried to make a thing that was on the telly or in a magazine, out of construction paper or whatever, it was fucked. It was always fucked.
Let's make a visor. First, you'll need to gather a few things together. You'll need cardboard, a dinner plate. Let's begin. Place the dinner plate part. Staple one end of the elastic to.
You could sample that and throw that into a song if you really needed to. Ozzy's not charging.
Do you like to race? Well, welcome to the ice cube race.
What the fuck is this lame idea?
Which color will melt its ice cubes the fastest? Which color do you think it might be? Write down your choices. All right, let's get ready. For this experiment, you'll need several sheets of colored construction paper, including black and white. Spread your sheets of colored paper out flat in
the
direction.
Say that again.
Spread your sheets of colored. Watch carefully as the race begins. Which color seems to be winning? Measure the water from each of the ice bags and chart the information. Are they based on your findings? Which color melted the ice the fastest? The answer is
no one cares. Well, I don't know. Handler not defined.
Let's find out how we can tell time without a watch or clock. There will be the N also.
Arts and crafts.
Have you ever felt the wind? Was it strong or gentle? Wind is an...
It's just a lot of arts and crafts. I mean, it's like extended activities because there's not much of a game here. There's like minimal game. Why is that apple rotten?
Hi, did you know that right now the Earth is spinning like a top? We don't feel dizzy because the planet Earth is so big we can't feel it moving. It may seem as if we're standing still and the sun is moving around us, but the Earth spinning round and round is what gives us day and night.
Yeah, that's bullshit.
Let's see
it's
how
flat.
That works.
There's no spinning.
For this experiment,
I watched a couple YouTube videos. The Earth's flat.
String, a toothpick, and a flashlight. Tie a string around the stem of an apple. Stick a toothpick into the side of the apple.
Wait. Is this
a room that...
Are you telling me that the Earth is in the shape of an apple?
Turn the Earth apple slowly by twisting...
Earth apple, I heard it. Well, you make a very convincing argument. You know what? From that, I'm going to extrapolate that space is also fake. And the Earth apple is, in fact, the real shape of our planet.
Did the sun ever feel hot to you? That's
yeah,
called
kinda
solar
does.
Power. And solar
yep.
power can be used for lots of things.
Oh!
But did you know that you can cook with it? For this experiment, you'll see how the heat of the sun can roast a hot dog for you to eat. For this activity, you'll need 8 things.
Yeah, I want to eat a raw hot dog.
Oatmeal box, a pair of scissors.
Smart. Yeah, get
tape,
kids sick.
Aluminum foil, wire cutters. A wire coat hanger, a pre-cooked hot dog, and
a
sunny day.
It's gotta be pre-cooked. Okay, all right, fair enough.
First, cut out half
of the oatmeal box's side. They are pre-cooked, but you still don't want to eat like a hot dog right out the pack.
Then tape the lid back
onto the box. Oh God, does anyone do that?
Punch a hole in the center of the top and bottom of the box.
Don't tell me that there's probably someone out there in the world that's buying hot dogs, opening the pack, and just fucking chomping on them at their computer like they would, like a fruit roll-up, or a polio cheese stick, or whatever. They can't... That's disgusting. That is fucking disgusting. No, I don't do that. You gotta cook... Just cook the hot dog a little bit. Make it hot! That's why it's called hot dog.
Now, line the whole inside of the box with aluminum foil. Shiny side up. Ask an adult. Okay, you're ready to roast a hot dog. To do it, you just slip the coat hanger wire back out of one end of the cooker. Slide a hot dog onto it. Just place your shoulder...
Slide a hot dog onto it. I don't want to hear that ever again. Someone in chat just said, Vinny, medium rare chicken was a trend on Twitter a couple years ago. Just burn it down. I say we let the apple earth just rot. Delicious salmonella. God, leave it a little medium.
Hey, Ozzy. I haven't finished cleaning this part of the ocean yet. Don't get caught in my line.
Hey, Rufus! I'm not garbage!
His neck has been pierced.
I told you! I wasn't done cleaning yet.
Rufus, what do you do here every day anyway?
I'm doing very important work here. keeping the ocean clean and safe for our friends in the neighborhood.
Rufus?
What, Ozzy?
Why do people throw away their junk in our home?
Oh, I'm not sure, Ozzy. But I guess they don't know just how much it hurts us. I'm almost done for today. Wanna help tomorrow?
Okay, I'll be back then.
Well. Man, I remember when I played games like this at the computer lab in grade school. And there was like a lot of positivity in these games. I was like, man, we're all great. All people are great. We're at the height of civilization. And everything's amazing. And then you get older and you learn like one day at a time. You're like, oh, fuck. Like, I saw someone doing some kind of challenge. There's a new challenge. It might be fake. But it was someone licking in the bathroom of an airplane. Like, yesterday. And that was their Instagram trending challenge. I don't know if or TikTok or whatever. I hope that was fake.
What is this seaweed? I can't see a thing.
Pick a shell. Any shell. Guess again. Good guess. Try again later.
I think, I think the thing about that is, so people are saying it was real. Okay, so even if there is no threat of a virus, let's say, and you're just licking a bathroom or a toilet seat in a plane, the goal, I guess, is to become famous from that and to get more subscribers and to have it go viral. Interesting choice of words. But imagine becoming famous for licking a toilet seat. What kind of fucking fame do you want, bitch? What kind of example are you setting? Don't do that. And now, like, you know, at least three other dumbasses across the world are going to lick a toilet seat. Chat. Just don't do it. All right? It's not worth it. It's not even fun. Licking toilet seats, I would know.
Sometimes we don't know how our actions may hurt others on our planet. Something as simple as throwing away plastic six-pack rings can hurt baby seals. They might swim into it, and because they have no arms, they can't get it off. In this simple exercise, you will learn how it feels to be tangled up in litter and unable to free yourself. Then, you will learn an easy way that you can make a difference.
Very close to the microphone and very, very.
Okay.
All you need is a plastic six-pack ring, a rubber band, and a pair. First, slip the rubber band over your thumb and stretch. Now, try to get free without using anything else to help you, not even your other hand.
Not even taking a moment to breathe like the other narrator did in between sentences and words. We don't breathe, we keep reading.
Dunk your hand into a sink full of water. Pretend you are a baby seal trying to get loose from some beach trash. Whew! Now, you can see why it's important to keep trash where it belongs and not in the water where it can hurt a small water animal.
I mean, the message here is good, right? You know, save some baby seals, but why is this fucking hilarious? It's beach trash, the narration.
One small pretend you're a baby thing seal. You can do to make a big difference is to snip the rings of a six-pack holder before you throw it away.
Thank you. Oh, man.
I'm just going to assume that everything is a hidden image. Even if I see nothing.
Nope.
Oh. Of course that was a turtle. That was a giant fish.
I don't think so.
Of course. Why would that not be a bird?
Sorry.
I don't think so.
A little concentrated burst of insanity for you. I don't know why so many of these fuckers are squeezing mustard all over themselves, but...
Yummy!
I'll be more careful next time.
Do you ever spill anything that's hard to clean up? Well, what's all the fuss about when you hear of an oil spill in the ocean?
Yes, mustard.
Can't they just wipe it up and be done with it? This experiment shows just how tricky that can be and why it's so important to clean up thoroughly when it happens. Do you think you can clean up an oil spill? These are some things you will need.
First, Hitachi magic wand.
You'll need a few things to create your ocean and oil spill. A bucket, some vegetable oil, a spoon, a sponge, some cotton balls, a baster, and anything else that you would like to try using. You may get your own ideas later on. Also, find a feather, some floating toys, a duck and a boat would be good choices. Now, you're ready. To form the ocean, fill the bucket with water. Pour in some vegetable oil and watch as it forms a big, colorful slick across the surface of the water.
Now.
Notice that it doesn't mix with the water. It stays on top.
Now, all right, first of all, before you get in the bucket, I need you to go into your mom's room. Go into the top drawer. It should be the sock drawer. And just take a little reach and a gander right to the back of the sock drawer and see if you find anything hard. If you do, then you're in the right
place. Add your toys to the ocean bucket to make it seem more real. You can pretend that your toy boat made the oil spill.
Well.
Dip the feather into the oil slick and pull it out again. What happened to it? What would a bird caught in an oil slick look like? What would it feel like?
The delivery is amazing.
Okay, now's your chance to be a hero. Save the birds and sea animals by removing the oil from the water. Try using all of the different tools you've collected. It's not easy, is it? It always seems to get away from you. But you're a hero today, so I know you can do it. Which method works the best?
Oh, man. Again, they're trying to send good messages. They're trying to, you know, teach the kids how to be responsible. I understand that. It's just hilarious.
Waterman dares you to take the water challenge.
You see what I mean?
How
do I take this seriously?
How much water do you think you use in a day? A gallon? Two? Three? Just how big is a gallon? Get an adult to help you. Water is heavy.
Help you.
The challenge is this. Try to get by for a whole day on just 1 gallon of water. Fill a clean, empty gallon jug with water and see if you can get by on it for a whole day. It looks like a lot, but is it? Watch this. It would have to include everything. Washing your hands and face, rinsing your dishes, and all of your drinks for the day. If you want juice, it would have to be made from the gallon of water. Don't forget your bath and taking care of your plants.
Yeah, that's not happening. This is going to be stinky kids. Stinky kids all across America.
Don't count flushing. But even brushing your teeth has to be included. You can't use the faucet all day. That's the challenge. Can you do it?
But you can flush your turds down the toilet. Okay, good. At least we have permission. We have permission. Now, chat, that's not a toothbrush, because you can see, we know what a gallon of water looks like, right? A gallon of water is huge compared to a toothbrush. That's not a toothbrush. That's a fucking toilet brush that you use to clean a toilet. So, whatever the fuck you want to do with that, have fun.
Whale. This is a big whale. How big
is the largest animal that ever lived? A dinosaur? Ooh, they sure were big. It's hard to imagine animals as huge as they were. But did you know that whales are even bigger?
Whales are even bigger?
A blue whale can reach up to 100 feet from head to fluke. 100 feet to stretch the string out on a long safe pavement. Hold the string up against your house. Would a whale fit inside your home? What if you had a whale friend and it wanted to sleep over?
You don't need any context for that. Chat, just take this out of context.
What if you had a whale friend and it wanted to sleep over? Could it fit in your bed or wear your t-shirt?
Just take all of that out of context. Enjoy.
Now, stretch the string out again. Lay down at one end of the string and see how big the... Do the same thing at the front end of your imaginary whale, only going out sideways. Measure out 20 feet.
This whale looks like an internet troll.
The whale is 5 times your height, or 2 times as high as a basketball hoop. Cowabunga!
Did you just say hoop?
That's a pretty big friend. Show your friends how big a whale is.
I don't know what I liked more, cowabunga or hoop.
Do the same thing at the front end of your imaginary whale, only going out sideways. Measure out 20 feet. If you're 4 feet tall, the whale is 5 times your height, or 2 times as high as a basketball hoop.
I never heard it said like that, so much so that my mouth made a fart noise. This is proving to be way more entertaining than I expected. I just wonder, like, how many kids got this game actually went outside with the string? Blomby, what are you doing with the string?
I almost as high as a whale.
What?
It's a tots, double hop.
Okay, just be back before dinner. Had to wait for that animation to play for some reason.
Do you like to draw or see pretty colors? Well, Rain can be a creative artist. The next rainy day, using watercolor paint, make a design of colors over the whole paper. Now that the pattern is dry, put it outside in a gentle rain. When you bring the painting in from outside, let it dry again. You'll be amazed at the interesting pattern that the raindrops made for you. Yes, your rain paintings have very special designs.
Couldn't they just sell this game as a book?
To play Ozzy's matchup hair game, click on one of the tiles above, then try to find the tile that matches the one.
Eagle.
Pig.
Pop filter.
Turtle. Slimy snake.
Oh my god.
Bunny rabbit. Monkey. Monkey. Eagle. Eagle. Bunny rabbit. Bunny rabbit.
Elephant.
Turtle.
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 God, I love these unprofessional as fuck games. I like that they just like got someone from the staff of the game development team to just like speak into a shitty microphone without a pop filter.
Pig. Pig.
Elephant. Elephant. Slime. Monkey. Elephant.
Oh, now I can't see.
Horse. Bunny rabbit.
It's Ozzy.
Ducky duck.
I definitely didn't click on the duck, but...
Turtle.
Do you like the water?
Have you ever tried
to open your eyes underwater? Without special goggles or underwater viewer, everything is blurry, and you can't see much.
Who the fuck
does
this?
We're going to learn how to make such a viewer, so that you can see underwater clearly. To make the viewer, you'll need an empty half-gallon carton, some scissors, a rubber band, and some plastic wrap.
No, I mean specifically, like, the image that was shown where someone's sticking their head in, like sea life, ocean, or like, a pond, and they're just, yes, I will look with my eyes as I stick my head. I don't think anyone does that. Maybe, you know what? Someone's done it. Then again, people eat raw hot dogs, so whatever. Just keep in mind, chat, I still don't have confirmation that people eat hot dogs cold, like, right out the pack. But I now live in a post-cold hot dog world. Even though I got no confirmation, it had never even occurred to me that someone would be eating hot dogs. So now there's two worlds. There was the pre-hot dog and post-hot dog world, and I don't like it. I don't like it.
Cut the carton across the top and the bottom. Place a sheet of plastic wrap over one end of the... Now, put the viewer in the water with the plastic wrap side down. If you tried to look in the water without the underwater viewer, you couldn't see clearly. Surprise! Now, the picture
is clear.
It's Bungie.
Surprise! Did he say the picture is cleat?
Surprise! Now, the picture is clear.
Oh. Bungette. Okay, we're almost done with this garbage. Again, it oddly...
Ozzy, your friend is here!
It's Ozzy entertaining.
There you are. Did I show you my latest experiment? I was in my hideout working on it. We can play with it later. Did you see my new sundial? It's over there, in the window.
Oh, Ozzy, don't forget to water the garden before you leave.
Okay, Mom!
Vinny Mailbox? What did I miss? Can you find the sexy flower? Okay, we'll go there in a bit, sadly. The ocean mailbox. Oh, right. How the fuck did I miss that? It is right there. Me!
Mom! Dad! I've been adopted!
I said snail, not whale.
Oh, let's keep him. He's so cute.
Cool. Thanks, Meats.
How would you like to have the biggest pet on the block? You and your family can adopt a whale.
This is lies.
Help save the lives of whales and other endangered animals.
This is lies. You know what? You're going to get a certificate saying you own a whale. Right? Just like when you own a piece of land on the moon. And then when they colonize the moon, that certificate will be worthless.
For $15, you will receive an official whale adoption certificate and a photograph of your whale. You will also receive a year subscription to the Whale Watch newsletter for updates on the activities and whereabouts of your chosen whale. Did I say chosen? That's right. You can choose which whale you want to adopt from a photograph. And the adoption papers will include your name and the name of your whale. Bet you didn't know whales had names.
Well, I mean, they don't, but people gave whales names. They have people names. I mean, it's, you know, I get the idea of it. I think it's a good idea to help save the whales. You send the $15. Remember, this is, you know, Save the Whales was still a big thing. Free Willy was a big movie. You'll notice it's a very whale-centric game. The Star Trek 4 movie was about saving whale. Vinny, you can still do this. Well, that's nice. Vinny, whales do have names for each other, but they just don't speak human. Oh, no shit.
Another thing you can do to help save the whales is to write or draw a letter. Even though most countries in the world have stopped killing whales, there are a few that refuse to quit. Oof. They are Japan and Norway. You can write to them and the President of the United States at these addresses. Are you just learning to write?
All right.
Then draw a picture instead. Have an adult help you with a few words. Letters are a very good way to make great changes in the world. It's one way you can help our friends, the whales. If you want, tell your folks what you want to say, and they can write it down for you.
All right, why am I getting all these letters? I don't understand. I got about 35 letters today from a bunch of kids scribbled in crayon telling me to send a nuclear weapon to Japan and Norway. I don't get it. I just don't understand it.
Again, I don't know how popular this game was. Apparently, chat knows about the game, and a lot of people actually owned it. Which blows my mind, but I wonder how many people did these things.
You always have trouble with that hoe.
I wish I could get stats.
Bungie, where are you hiding now?
Hey, Ozzy, I want you to plant more of these great vegetables. So I can eat them. And build my cocoon, because I can't wait to become a butterfly. I really like the lettuce.
Hey, Bungie, where'd you go?
Bungie?
Hey, I'll look for Bungie in the shed. You look for him in the garden.
What?
I'll bet you'll find a lot of other neat things as well.
Bungie. I can't escape Bungie. It's the plant version of Bungie. Oh, wait, what was it? What was he looking for again? Then he clicked the sexy flower. That's all I've been seeing for the past 10 minutes. There's a caterpillar. Sorry, okay. So here's the sexy flower. Oh, no. Okay, that was a little weird, but it was a little less weird than I was expecting based on the chat's reaction. I thought it was going to get a little worse than that.
Have you ever wanted to
pluck
a flower?
Would you like to give a present to someone? Here is a way you can share beautiful plants with others. All you need to make new plants are pieces from the plants you have. Some good choices to start with are some houseplants, herbs, a cactus, flowers, or vines.
What?
When you get some new plants started, you can give them away to your friends.
Yeah, no.
Ask if it's all right to cut a healthy branch from a plant in your house. Fill a pot with clean, damp sand. Check the plant each day. If the plant seems to wilt, cut the top third of a plastic liter-sized pop bottle and turn it over the plant. After about 6 weeks, there will be roots on the stem of the cutting.
The first thing I thought of when people were saying sexy flower was the sexy flower from Conquer. Yeah, pop. Remember, it's soda in some parts of the world. It's pop in others. And then some places in the United States just call it cola or Coke. Like, they will call every soda Coke, which I will never get. But then again, we do call tissues Kleenex. So. And dumpsters. You know, dumpsters are actually a brand. Who? We? Some? Yeah, dumpster is a brand, isn't it? People just call them dumpsters, but it was a brand that became the name of the thing. So, Zipper is also a brand. Slapstick, Three Stooges. Gross.
Have you ever seen a yellow flower as tall as your parents? That's a sunflower. For this activity, you must first plant a sunflower seed and watch it grow into a huge sunflower plant.
Guarantee this would never happen.
Then, when it's time to cut them down, you can enjoy a delicious and crunchy snack right from your very own sunflower.
Try growing your own sunflower. I'm sure that would happen.
When the petals fall from your sunflower and the birds are pecking at the seeds, it's harvest time. Cut off the sunflower, leaving about a foot of stalk. Hang the sunflower upside down in a dry and airy place. When the seeds are dry, rub them off with your hand. When you're ready for a snack, shell the seeds and put them on a cookie sheet. Bake in an oven at 350 degrees Fahrenheit for 5 minutes.
Some people are saying that sunflowers are difficult to grow, and others are saying they're not at all difficult to grow. I would think that they were difficult to grow because they get tall and they maybe would require some looking after to survive. Then again, I fucked up a corn plant when I was a kid, so. And other plants later on in life. Yeah, I was a farmer for a short time. There was a time.
Thanks. No problem.
Have you seen a rainbow? Do you remember where you saw it? On a side, a rainbow is made.
Okay, we're gonna try to get through this a little bit more quickly. There's a potato in a jar.
I'm sprouting in here.
All right.
Did you know that it is possible to grow a plant without any seeds? In this experiment, you will see how by using only a sweet potato and water, you can grow a plant. Ask your parents
for a sweet
potato.
Looks like a bootleg California raisin.
And you'll be ready to go.
Also, looks like what I was using before when I was coloring, and I was just using wacky colors.
All you need for this activity is a stick 4 toothpicks into your sweet. Keep the jar in a well-lighted spot, but not in direct sunlight.
And this is how Portal 2 happened.
To play Ozzy's matchup hair game.
Corn.
Tomato. Greeny bean.
Chili pepper.
I like, as he says chili pepper, you hear someone else speaking in the background.
Potato.
Chili pepper.
Cabbage. Sunflower.
Carrot.
Watermelon.
Carrot. Carrot.
Cauliflower.
Carrot.
What level was this dude operating when he said carrot? Like,
cabbage.
Was he like 7 out of 10?
Carrot.
One thing every garden needs is a scarecrow. There are lots of fun to make. To make a scarecrow, you'll need to gather together a hat, an old pair of... Using the string, tie the sticks together near the top.
Wait.
Like a cross. Stuff the pillowcase full of straw and tie it.
Nail the scarecrow to the cross. Wait 3 days and then bury him in a cave. Now, don't forget to move the rock over the cave.
Draw a face on the pillowcase. Make sure you have the open end down where the neck would be.
And then wait and see what happens. Congratulations, you started a scarecrow religion.
You can dress your scarecrow up as fancy or as simple as you want to.
Oh, you have to wait 3 days after. Oh, right. Yes, I see. I forgot my stories.
Have you ever taken a look at a bird's nest?
Ask me anything Lord of the Rings related, and I got you.
You know, birds use a lot of different things to make their nests. You'll have a surprise when you look through a magnifying glass and see seeds, bits of string, shiny pieces, feathers, and other things in, as well as sticks, twigs, grass, and mud.
And scum.
In the fall, when the leaves fall off of the trees, you can spot empty birds' nests easily. Most of the time, an empty nest is okay to take home. But sometimes, something else may have moved in when
Wait, what if it has scabies?
Out. Check the nest over carefully for any signs that a mouse, insect, or other creature has made its home there. If it has, keep looking for a nest that no one is using. Do you have a place to look? Take a magnifying glass with you to look at the nest up close. Surprise!
I mean,
what did you find?
If it's not high up on the tree.
Take the nest home with you and place it in a bowl.
No!
Water it and keep it moist for a week or two. Because there are seeds in nests, you will soon see sprouts growing out of the nest. Show your friends what you found.
I don't like this idea very much. This is probably very smelly. Yeah, no, I don't think that's a good idea. Gonna have to pass on that one. This activity center, full of bad ideas.
How would you like to grow your very own tree? You don't even need a big backyard. Dry your seed for a day or two. Place the seed base down. Carefully place the jar in a... Put some gravel in the bottom of a flower pot. Cover...
Alright. I missed some stuff. I'm gonna go back... Well, what's this?
Did you ever wonder what it would be like to be a bug? Imagine what the world would look like to a tiny little insect. What would a flower look like if you were a honeybee?
Not really.
Look around your yard for a caterpillar, ladybug,
it's like a happy Shrek.
And other friendly insect. Try to imagine what you looked like to them. Get real close to the ground and look for any insects. There are lots of them. If you now see if you can catch a bug or two. First, after you watch it for a bug you'll like to watch is the lightning bug.
No. The activity center is all nice and again, I'm sure someone would enjoy doing this stuff. I don't think I would have done this even as a kid. Or just let
Come in, Annie.
Whatever.
Annie, come in!
I would have just played the games and then stopped. There's not much here to learn.
What would it be like to be a tree?
Jesus
fucking Christ.
Can
you imagine all of the things that they see in their long lives? Some trees are thousands of years old. Imagine the stories they could tell if we could only hear them. Maybe
Help! I'm stuck in a tree!
Become a tree,
Help!
You could understand them better.
Get me out of here!
Do you want to try? Okay.
Help!
Just listen closely and use your imagination.
I can't get out of the tree. I don't know why I'm in the tree.
The
My spirit is locked in this tree. Oh.
I see you in chat, Lumpy.
One glorious summer morning, you're walking through a meadow filled with dandelions and flowers. All around you, there's a warm, tingly feeling in the air. Without warning, your toes begin to grow. You look down at them and watch them as they grow right out of your shoes. This... It tickles and it makes you laugh. You can no longer use your legs to walk as your toenails dig deep into the soft earth, but you don't mind. You know something wonderful is happening. You feel your toes growing longer and longer and reaching deeper until you're anchored in this spot. Your skin begins to turn rough and hard.
I hate it. Oh, this is disgusting. Dude, it's like in Link to the Past when that kid turned into a tree. That really freaked me out. I don't like this. I mean, yeah, it's not that big of a deal. But I still don't like it.
As each second passes,
so
your body
ugly.
And arms are becoming stiff. You can move them a little, such as when a breeze pushes against them, but that's all. Your fingertips and hair feel electric as they begin to dance in the wind. Soon your mouth closes and you can no longer talk. The only noise you can make is the rustling of your leaves and an occasional creak of your trunk. All of this excitement has made you very thirsty. So you soak water into your roots and slowly push it up through your trunk, down each limb to feed the leaves on each branch and twig.
I mean, there's like talking trees with faces in Link to the Past, so why not?
You can tell from the position of the sun that it's well past lunchtime, and you begin to feel quite hungry. You know it will be impossible to eat in your usual way, since you have no mouth or teeth to chew. As you try to think through this problem, you realize that your leaves are now full of water, and you're grabbing rays of sunshine. They are using the sun's energy to make food. Your leaves use part of the water and part of the surrounding air to make sugar. Slowly, the sweet food is pumped down the branches and through the trunk to every part of your body. It tastes good and satisfies your raging hunger. You think
raging
yourself,
hunger, you say, huh?
Now that's a good lunch!
I get that it's supposed to be educational, but isn't there a better way to do this?
But since you can no longer move your head from side to side, it's difficult
Come on,
to look
you know.
Around. But with your eyes, you spy a little brown squirrel searching for food near you. As he scampers up your trunk, his claws tickle your bark as if someone were lightly scratching what was once your back.
Why is this
he
fun?
He finds a nut on one of your branches and plucks it away. Ow! You felt that. It didn't really hurt. It just startled you because it felt odd, like something was being lifted away.
I'd want to kill
Suddenly,
the squirrel.
You feel your roots being tickled by a bunny's nose as she sniffs around your roots. The squirrel tickles you again as he darts down your trunk and scampers away. You listen for him, but instead you hear crows calling in the distance. Caw, caw, caw. They're heading this way. Huh. You feel a pinch, then another, and another. Three large black crows perch themselves on your branches and begin to quarrel.
But you can't
Suddenly, move. The wind picks up and you sway back and forth in the breeze. This startles the crows and they noisily fly away. Caw, caw, until you can no longer hear their piercing calls. Soon you're alone in the meadow with just the flowers and the breeze, which you notice is getting stronger.
It sounds like a nightmare that all these things are like taking things from you or pecking you or scratching you and you can't do anything about it. I feel bad for trees now.
It isn't long before you notice that the sun has been covered up by dark rain clouds. Pitter-patter, drip-drop, splash! Big raindrops began to fall. Now your leaves are spreading out to catch the droplets and protect you like an umbrella. The soft, cool water is comforting after standing in the hot sun all afternoon. The rain washes the dust from your leaves and branches in the same way that water used to bathe you in the shower at home. You see a crack of light streak across the sky. Then, crash! You hear the rolling thunder. That sounded close! You watch the lightning dance across the darkening sky. It's like a fireworks display on the 4th of July.
And then you get hit by the fucking lightning and burn.
And another. My, how different it would be to be a tree!
Thunderstruck! Thunderstruck! Ow!
This is horrible. It's just the way it's being narrated. It's such a weird concept. This tree looks like it's saying, ugh. Like, it's just not a good thing to perceive or think about. It's a bad thought experiment. There, I said it.
Rainforests are the richest areas of plants and wildlife on the entire planet. They only cover a small part of the globe around the equator. The things you'll need for this, ask for help from an adult on next. Turn the soda bottle, put about next. Put about one inch of gravel into the bottom of the piece.
Sounds like Mel from Flight of the Conchords, Kristen
Schaal. Spread a layer of charcoal over it. Fill the rest of it with potting soil. Then, carefully transplant the tropical plant.
What's her name in Bob's Burgers?
Dig a small hole in the soil.
Who does she play, Louise?
Gently remove the plants from their pots and place them in the holes.
Belinda.
Press the soil around
lightly. Belinda, get your sister. We need to split.
Now water the plants with about a third cup of water. Good job!
Yes. Belinda, it is I, your father, Bob. Today we need to split. We need to split your brother into five guys.
Father, how do you spell your name?
B-A-L-B, Bulb. That is my name, my child. Are you ready to make the tastiest, most juiciest burgers that could ever exist on planet Earth?
Yes, Father.
All right, first you must become a tree, for we need wood for the grill. So, dream clone number 7, you will become a tree. And then we will cut you down and use your wood to fire up the grill.
Yes, Father.
Spare no expense, Treeb.
You see a huge tree, strong and solid. Standing next to it, you may feel like a tiny ant as you gaze up into its looming branches. You know that paper is made from trees, but you wonder, how in the world can they turn this monster of a tree into a sheet of paper so
he's
I can
dead.
Draw and write?
Oh no, he's
then
dead!
Then you stand back and you watch as the sound of a chainsaw fills the air. With a loud crack, the giant tree crashes to the ground. The forester turns and winks at you and says, keep watching.
That was the person trapped inside the tree.
It starts with a tree farm planting little tree seedlings. But
Dream,
you can't
I'm
be
old
in a
now.
Hurry. It takes 30 years or more before a tree is ready to be harvested. And twice as long in the night. After the tree is cut down
Ow.
And all of the branches are cut off and used for biomass, then the remaining log is cut into lengths for transport. The length depends on how that particular tree will be shipped to the paper mill. One of the most common ways to send logs to the mills, at the mill, the bark is stripped off the logs. Then they are chopped into 1-inch square wood chips. The chips are cooked along with... This liquid is washed and poured into long conveyors cut...
Father, I shall become receipt paper. My biomass shall exceed all expectations.
Spare no expense, Treeb.
This is a fucking fever dream and a half. Oh yeah, save the whales. Fuck the trees. Good message, the game is sending. My God.
Isn't your pet the cutest?
first and most... What? Hi! Did you know... Use wood! When your birdhouse is... Use wood! Metal such as...
I wish to become a birdhouse, Father!
Hi! Have you ever been to the zoo? Did the animals look happy or lonely? Or sad? What would it be like to be an animal in a zoo? In some places, it might be just fine. In others, it might not be that great. How would you feel? What kind of places are good for animals, and which need improvement? What is the best way to take care of caged animals? Let's find out. Make some pretend cages with string. Put a water bowl in each cage. Now, you go into one cage and have one friend go into another cage, and so on.
What?
Keep it one to a cage. If you want to, you can pretend to be animals. There's no talking allowed at this point. Stay in the cages for a long time this way. How does it make you feel?
The art. Oh,
when
my
you can
gosh.
Stand it no longer,
it's feral children.
Toy to each of the cages. But still, you cannot talk to each other. Just play by yourself in your own cage. How is it now? Tell me how you feel.
I don't know. Why are you threatening me?
Now, let's try to make it better. Put two or more in the same cage. Now, you can talk and play as much as you want, but you still can't go outside of the cage. How does this feel compared to the first cage? How does it compare to complete freedom?
How does it
freedom?
Feel, bitch?
How can zoos make their places more fun for the animals that live there? Are the zoos good places for wild animals? How can they be better?
I mean, this
Make
is
some
just
pretend
social
cages
distancing.
With string. Put a what? Did you know that birds are really clean animals? They love to drive a 4x4 post into the ground. It should be about 4 feet high,
yes, Father,
and perfectly straight. Get help from a big... Find an old metal garbage can lid. Take the handle off. Turn it upside down, fasten the lid to the top of the post with three long screws and three rubber washers. But make sure the screws are tight so it won't leak. Fill your bird bath with water and wait.
This game is fucking fascinating.
Humans and animals have a lot in common. In our highly civilized Western culture, we sometimes forget that we have the same basic needs and characteristics as a lot of other creatures that... Lie down on a large sheet. Next, do... When you're finished,
Escape.
Now.
Escape.
Now.
Off, delete.
Locate.
Fuck.
What? Have you ever seen a flea or a tick? They're so small, you know. Tell your parents about a flea comb. It's... Here's another idea to help the pet you love. Make a flea sachet. Put a cup of dried mint leaves into a handkerchief or scrap of cloth. Bring all the ends together and tie them with a string or a rubber band. Now, try this. Add fresh foods, such as raw and cooked vegetables,
Kill
raw
your parents.
Eggs, garlic,
Kill your
and
parents.
Grains to help your pet fight insects that hurt.
Bury them in the backyard.
Would you like to make a flea spray to help your pet? Okay.
No, do not actually do this. Thank you. The preceding bit was a joke.
Do you like animals? So do I. And not just because I am one. You know, some animals need help. On October 1st, celebrate World Vegetarian Day. On that special day, do not eat any animal food. You can throw a party for your friends and serve only
a
vegetarian
meals and snacks.
A lot of
people took this very seriously.
At your local health food store, you can find vegetarian hot dogs, hamburgers, pizza, and a wide variety of delicious foods. These vegetarian
Except,
foods are much healthier than
you
meat.
Know,
Most of them supply protein without the fat and cholesterol that animal products have. So be kind and live long.
Right, pizza. Except in the case of a pandemic where people... will buy all the meat off the shelves, but leave all the vegan options.
Did you know some people steal my animal friends' coats and wear them for their own?
Oh, fuck you, PETA.
Would you like to know more about caring for your pet? Write to the Animal Welfare Institute.
Oh, God. Well, boy, I don't even...
Fuck! Did you know that...
Yeah, this was a thing. Is that it, then? Is that all of it? I think that's it, everybody. I think we've seen most of this nonsense. Oh, we got one more.
Do you like to make new sounds? Then try this. There's more than one way to recycle your trash. You can make new... Find two wooden blocks or sticks and clap them together. This kind of rain
clap
stick makes an excellent percussion sound. Take a paper towel tube and cover one end with a...
Yeah.
This one is awesome!
Beans!
Fill several clean, empty glass... Now, how about a stringed instrument?
Use beans for instrument.
Take a shoebox and make three or four snips on the short side directly across from each other. What's next? Drums, of course! Now you have enough instruments to have a real jam session with your friends. So go make some music. Let each person try out all the instruments. Will you name your band? Maybe you could put on a show.
Yeah, Bean Tube is my band name. Yeah, you know, we were just a band. We made a couple of instruments out of wood blocks. We had some bean tubes for Ringo. I made a guitar and a rubber band. It was just a band that we got real famous, that's all. And then there was a time where me and John, we were trying to write songs about being a tree, you know? I tried to become one myself, and then my joints got all stiff. And I had trouble speaking.
Yeah, Ozzy's World.
So that's, yeah, we called ourselves the Treetles after that one, you know? We were just a band.
Insane. What a game that was. Unintentionally and very intentionally disturbing at times. Thank you, chat member, for the Treetles. That was good. I enjoy it. Or the Beantles would have been nice, too. But I borrowed the Treetles. I wasn't that clever.
Hey, Treeb, what's your favorite band?